Hello, in this video I show you how to configure WireGuard VPN on Mikrotik router. Let's get started. I connect Mikrotik using Winbox. In Winbox you create a new WireGuard VPN interface. You can change the default port if you want, in this case I left it as default. Next I create a new subnet to allocate IP addresses for pairs of WireGuard VPN connections. I set the IP address 192.168.77.1 for the WireGuard interface on the Mikrotik router. This is the WireGuard interface I just created. Next, I set up the configuration file for the VPN client on the Windows computer. Go to the WireGuard homepage and download the installer for Windows. This is the WireGuard software after completing the installation on a Windows computer. On the Windows computer, I created a new tunnel and configured it to connect to the WireGuard server on Mikrotik. On the Mikrotik router, I added a new peer. You update the public key corresponding to the tunnel created on the Windows computer. Next, I set up the IP address for this peer. You set the IP address to the same subnet as set up in the previous step. In this case, I set this peer's IP address to 192.168.77.2. I set up the IP address the same as I set up on the Mikrotik router. Next, I set up the DNS address. On my Windows computer I also set up peer information. That is the information that has been set up on the Mikrotik router. You copy the public key from Mikrotik and paste it to the configuration on your Windows computer. Here I allow all IP addresses to access through the tunnel. The next configuration is the public IP address on the one interface of the Mikrotik router. WireGuard's default port is 13231. PersistentKeepalive 10. Don't forget to save your settings before connecting. On my Windows computer I set up a VPN connection to the Mikrotik router. Successful connection. Now from the Windows computer I can connect to the router or a local network through WireGuard. You do the same if you want to have more pairs. The Windows computer gets a new IP address from the WireGuard connection. I use the ping command to test the connection between my Windows computer and the Mikrotik router using VPN. For example, I connect to the Mikrotik router using the IP address on the WireGuard VPN connection. This is the traffic on the VPN connection that was just established. Above are the basic steps to create a WireGuard VPN connection on Mikrotik router. Next, I introduce advanced configuration when you use dynamic public IP addresses. If you use a dynamic public IP address like me, then you need a DuckDNS domain name. You can use another service if you want, but I like the DuckDNS service because it can be set up on many different devices. You just need to create a free DuckDNS account to give yourself free domain names. After getting the domain name, create a script to update the public IP address on the Mikrotik router. On the Mikrotik router, I created a new script, then copied the code above. In this code you replace the token and your corresponding domain name. This script will update the public IP address and map it to your domain name. Now you establish a VPN connection using a domain name instead of a public IP address. On the WireGuard client on the Windows computer, I edit the configuration file as follows. Instead of using public IP address, using domain name. After completing the configuration editing, I set up the VPN connection. The connection is successful, so you don't need to worry about using a dynamic public IP address. Finally, don't forget to schedule the public IP address update scripts to run. Follow these steps to schedule the run of the scripts file just created in the previous step. Above are the steps to configure WireGuard on Mikrotik router. Thank you for watching, don't forget to like and subscribe. Good luck!